Hi guys, welcome back to another GGF video review. Today we're checking out probably the most badass keyboard you can get on the market today. It's the CM Storm Mech by Cooler Master. It's a full cherry mechanical keyboard. It comes in blue, red or brown switches currently, and the model we got today to review is the blue switch model. This belongs to the aluminium series from CM Storm. So this is the keyboard, which is the Mech, and there's also the Reaper mouse, which I've also got to review later on, and there's also the Pulse R headset as well. So you've got the three items there, and I'll be checking out the keyboard today. Some of the main features before I jump into covering the box and actually looking at the keyboard. This actually has a full USB 3 hub with two ports built into the back of the keyboard. And not only that, it actually has a USB sound card as well that connects to the USB 3 cable that plugs into your PC as well. So that actually gives you a headphone port and a microphone port, both on 3.5mm jacks, and there's a sound card built into the keyboard. So you don't actually need to run the extenders into the back of your sound card like most keyboards do that run along the cable. The other standout feature is this keyboard comes equipped with a handle. It comes with a handle on the left-hand side. You can't really see it on the box, but we'll cover that later on. Unfortunately, this handle isn't removable. It does make the keyboard slightly larger, but it is pretty sweet. It has a handle if you're going to gaming events and so on. Some other standout features are the lighting modes. It's got some pretty funky lighting modes, some different settings you can change. This is fully backlit. It's got a white backlit, laser etch keys, and it does look really nice. I'll cover those as well. And the final standout feature is this top aluminium cover. With this aluminium series, with the keyboard, the mouse, and the headset, each part that's aluminium can be removed, and you can paint these, mod these. I'll put up a few screenshots of some that have been modded already. They do look pretty sweet. If you've got a team, you can get a team theme done on, say, your keyboard, mouse, and headset, and it does look pretty sweet. So I'll show you some of those as well. That's pretty much it for the standout features. We'll just go over and have a look at what's on the box, and just quickly go over the box. I don't want to spend too long on the box because this is a large keyboard. I want to cover it all. And also, I'll go through the software as well because it's got a good application suite as well that comes with this. So I'll just have a quick look at the box. One thing you'll notice that the box is absolutely huge. It's also probably because the keyboard is rather large as well. I believe it comes in at about 1.6 kilos. So if you're after a small keyboard for traveling, this probably isn't the keyboard for you. But if you're after an all-rounder keyboard for gaming, for anything, and you're not worried about size, this will certainly suit your needs. Just a comparison, here are a few 780 boxes, and you can still see that it's actually still longer. It's just absolutely massive, this box. That's the front of the box. There's probably not too much to cover on there. I've covered it in the introduction, and more on the back. It doesn't really have anything. It does have a powerful 72 megahertz rapid fire engine. It actually has macros you can save on the keyboard. You can actually configure the macros within the keyboard. You don't need the software to be installed to do that. So it does have a memory as well on board for that. Removable cover, USB ports, and it's got the steel plate in that which you can remove. We'll just jump in now and just have a look inside the box. Right, so once you open the box, I have had this keyboard out for testing. I do like to test the products before I review them, so there might be a few sort of marks here or there during the testing phase. So one thing it does come with is plenty of foam, so at least you're guaranteed that your keyboard is going to come in one piece. That's the keyboard there. First thing you probably notice, there's no cable attached. That's because it is removable. It's a standard USB 3 cable, which I think is a really neat idea. If you have any other full-size USB 3 device, like a USB hard drive, something like that, you can just use that cable. So if you do lose your cable or you want spares, you just need a USB 3 cable. What else in the box is you just have a little warranty information, just information about the product, and you also have a sort of double-sided quick start guide. You've got your LED options, your media keys, and then how to configure the we'll just move down a bit, just how to configure the macros and that without the software. So I'll cover that a little bit later on. And down below we actually have a keycap remover, and we also have a Allen key to remove the top plate cover if you want to. And then last but not least is the standard USB 3 cable, which you can just plug straight into the back like so, just like that, and then that's it. The length of this, I'll just undo it to quickly see. So it does give you the option to buy a longer cable if you want off eBay, just anywhere. This cable is probably about 1.5, 1.3 meters, so it is long enough. It's nice and thick as well. Okay, so we'll just get a closer look on the keyboard, and I'll fire it up and we'll have a look at the different lighting modes. So the keyboard's plugged in now. I don't have the LED backlights on. I'll save that when I've got the lights off. Just to show you that this is the blue switch. You can see it there. That's the blue one there. We'll just cover the keys along the top, some of the hot keys. So you've got the LEDs either on or off. You've got brightness up or down, down, up. Then you've got your different modes. I'll show you that once I've got the lights down. You can change it to full backlighting, certain keys. You got your play, pause, stop, next track, previous track, and then we have your mute, and we also got volume up and down, and then we have the Windows disable key. Moving on to some more of the function keys, you've got the FN keys here. The Windows keys are replaced by FN keys. It's on this side and on the left side. And then the Windows key still works, it's just FN instead. I'll just show you quickly how to record a macro. I just looked at the instructions, it's really simple. If you want to do this outside of the software, it's probably best to do it in the software, but if you want to do it outside of the software, you just go FN, and then you hit number 1 to 5, so I'll go FN 1, so that's profile 1. Then you hold FN and Alt until caps lock starts blinking down here. Once it starts blinking, you can record your macro. So I'll do Windows key E, that opens Explorer. Now if I hold FN and Alt to finish it again, that finishes it, and then I just choose which shortcut macro key. So I'll go M5, will trigger that. Caps lock stops, and now M5 now opens up Windows Explorer. That's pretty sweet, pretty quick to do that. It's not too advanced. If you did it in the software, you'll be able to set up timings and more functions. It also says there's a limit of 25 characters when doing this mode, and 30 seconds it can record till. So that's quite a fair bit. If you add an event, you don't have the software handy, it just gives you some functionality to be able to have a look at that. All right, so I've dimmed the lights a bit so we can actually see the backlighting now. As you can see, the F12's lit up. That one lights up when you've got Windows key disabled. So currently Windows keys are disabled. To turn on the backlighting, you just go FN, then the first F1. I'll go all the way back down to the original mode, which is this one here. So the original mode is all LEDs on, and you can set the brightness to all the way off. Yep, and then you can go up 1, 2, 3, 4. Four settings of brightness. So we've got all keys lit. You've got pulsating mode like that. It just goes in a cycle. And then the next one is you've just got your macro keys lit, your WASD and your arrow keys. And I believe that's the last one. And then it just goes back to the original one. So it is really nice backlighting. It's probably hard to pick up in the camera. It might just blur out a bit. But it is really nice, and it's not overly bright, and the fact that you can just put the function F2 down to dim it is also good. I'll just take this cover off so we can actually have a look what's under it and see how easy it would be to mod this cover. So once you've undone the 7 screws around the side, just standard little screws like that with the Allen key, you can just take the cover off and then you can do whatever you like. It is aluminium. The only thing, if you do paint it, you will sort of cover up. It's going to be hard to see, but there's slightly engraved symbols for the two USB, the microphone and the headset port. So you will cover that, but there's plenty of room if you want to put carbon fiber film over it, something that's not as permanent. You can paint it, you can do whatever you like. It's just a neat little feature. Before I go over the software, we'll just have a look at the handle design, and also it does have a micro USB on the back. That's a fast charge port for mobile devices, so that's handy that they've added that. And then again, your two USB 3, and then you've got your microphone and headphone ports there that run off the internal USB sound card in there. And then last but not least, just the handle design there. It is a really robust handle. It's actually joined into the whole keyboard, and it looks like it definitely cannot be removed, but it's not too bulky, but maybe just having the option to be able to remove it would be a nice feature as well. Okay, so the best way to get the software is to head to the CM Storm website. You can also just Google CM Storm Mech. It takes you straight to the product page. You go to the download tab, and it's about a 45 meg package to download. Once you install it and run it, each time you run this program, it does sort of a 5 to 10 second check. It talks to the keyboard to see if you've done any hardware level macro settings on the keyboard itself. So I did one previously in the video before, and it's actually picked those up. I did a few to play around with. So it's actually picked these up, and it's now sort of saved these within the software. There's three main tabs along the top. You've got Storm Config Profiles. This is a pretty cool area, and also your Macro Studio where you do all your settings. In the main tab here, this is where you do all your single button configuring. So say I want to do spacebar, we'll just go through the different options. You've got default key, which is pretty sweet, so you can default if you stuff something up. You've got single key, you can set it to something else. You've got macro. At first, before you do this, you've got to go into the Macro Studio to create a macro. Then you've got advanced. These are more sort of preset keys like volume up, volume down, keys like that. Let's see what else we've got. No function is pretty good. You can actually sort of not have a key do anything. And we've also got launcher program, so you can set it to like launch games, do whatever you like. This is pretty cool because then you don't have to worry about having a keyboard that has about 20 or 30 dedicated macros. You can set any macro to any key you like. Down the bottom we have our different profiles that you can set. I've actually deleted profile one. It says no profile, so I can just recreate that later. So it's got five profiles you can set. You can actually right-click and set an image, so you can theme these to games or whatever you like, so that's pretty handy. Moving over to the profiles, this is pretty cool because if you've made any profiles, set up any via the keyboard, which I did before, you can actually now copy these to Windows like that. And then if you've also made some in Windows and you want to take your keyboard out to a LAN and you're not sure if it's going to be on the same PC, you can then just copy it back up to the keyboard and it saves it on the keyboard. So it's pretty much sort of a backup and restore, or you can save it to your system or save it to your keyboard. And then the last tab we have over here is your macro recording studio. So if I have a look at M5, which I did before, so this was the Windows key one. So as you can see, it's noticed I held Windows key down for 1,150 milliseconds, and then I've hit E for just a little bit there. And then when you do that, it actually brings up, shows you that FN was pressed, the FN key, and then when I click on E, it shows you that E was pressed as well. So it's pretty sweet that it tells you, shows you all that, and it's quite advanced on what you can do. And if you scroll down, you can do a maximum of 25 characters, which would probably be plenty, because I've just done two to do Windows key E to start up Windows Explorer. So it's pretty advanced on some of the things you can do there. All right, so that's pretty much it for this review. I just wanted to go over the keyboard, some of the features. Some of the things I really liked about this is got the removable USB cable. That's really handy. You can keep a spare one at home. You can keep a spare one in your LAN bag. Having the aluminium cover that you can take off is definitely a unique feature, something that hasn't really been done before on keyboards. Having the USB 3 hub, I'm pretty sure there's maybe one other keyboard that has that, so that's also a very unique feature. And also having the handle, some people like the handle, some people won't. It's just sort of personal choice. And then also having the palm rest is a nice feature. Maybe just having the palm rest removable and also the handle removable would be really great features as well. I believe this keyboard retails for around $199, so right on the $200 mark. You do get a lot for your money. You get a really well built keyboard, tons of features, and it has a really nice LED backlighting as well. And then you also get the software as well, which I just ran through to do your advanced macro configs as well. So I want to thank CM Storm and Coolmaster for sending this out for review. And thanks for watching, and stay tuned for next time.